React, Svelte, Vue, Angular, Solid, Qwik. What do the numbers say in 2023? All the latest developer surveys are now out. You know what that means? It's time to dive in and see which framework is gaining ground, which framework is losing ground. This year we have three established frameworks in React, Angular and Vue, and three newcomers in Svelte, Solid and Qwik. We'll be taking a look at which frameworks are the most used and which are the most appreciated by developers. And then finally, I'll go into which framework or frameworks is worth learning in the coming months and why. We'll be looking at two main sources, namely the Stack Overflow Developer Survey and the State of JavaScript Survey. Now, what do those numbers say? Let's start by having a look at framework usage. The State of JavaScript Survey shows React ahead by far and without any sign of slowing down. Angular and Vue come next, but those are slowing down. Svelte is going strong, Solid is starting to grow, and Qwik has only just appeared on the scene. If we look at the JavaScript Rising Stars, which tracks the GitHub projects that have garnered the most stars over the past year, React is in the lead, and then we have three challengers, followed by Vue and Angular. Although to be fair, Vue has been split into Vue 2 and Vue 3, so combined they would be in second place. Now let's look at what developers say about these frameworks. The State of JavaScript survey compares, on the one hand, those who have used and those who want to use, and on the other hand, those who have used and don't want to use again, and those who are not interested in using it. Ordered by positive opinion, we have React first, followed by Svelte, Vue, Solid, Qwik, and then all the way down to Angular. The Stack Overflow Developer Survey shows very similar results, although both Solid and Qwik are too young to show up. We have Svelte coming out on top with about 75% of positive opinion. React has 68%, Vue has 63%, and then Angular has 52%. Incidentally, notice how all these surveys place React in the framework category. That's because although technically it is a library, functionally, it's a framework. The State of JavaScript survey has a fascinating view that shows the trajectories of the various frameworks between usage and positive sentiment. And this makes a lot of sense because the initial users of any technology will be the early adopters, the super fans who drive adoption. But when a given technology becomes used by everyone, when it becomes mainstream, that's when you see if it has staying power. To put it another way, the more a technology is used, the harder it is to get very high developer satisfaction. And that is what makes remarkable React's position in the optimal quadrant, the top right, of both usage and positive sentiment. Svelte looks to be heading in the right direction. Vue seems to be losing ground, although not as much as Angular. It's still early days for Solid, but early results look promising. And Qwik is just too young to show up at this stage. And I think this sums up where I stand in terms of these technologies. I think the market is at a stage where being proficient in React is a must-have for anyone who claims to be a front-end developer. At this point, there may well be opportunities in Vue or Angular based on where you live, but I feel they're not worth investing time in if you don't already know them. But what if you already know React or one of the other established frameworks and want to learn something new? On the other end of the spectrum, among the challengers, the situation is still very fluid. Qwik is still too young to have a settled place, and the same is true of Solid. Svelte, on the other hand, is starting to gain a foothold. It's fun to learn because the mental model is somewhat different from what you might be used to in the more established frameworks, notably React. And if you're interested in learning more about the subject, well, I'll see you in the next video.